Hey everybody, welcome to Yoga with Kathy Lighten. Today we are going to go over intentions to set the week of or for summer solstice, but hopefully these are things you can carry over into your day-to-day, everyday life, right? These are all really good intentions to have. They do specifically put emphasis on the sun. And that is the center of our solar system, right? It is why we're all here. The intention number one is to rise every day looking toward the rising sun. I think this is important. Lift your head up and breathe intentionally. Breathe mindfully, looking that direction and just being thankful for another day. As a yogi, it's essential to our practice to do Surya Namaskar, which are sun salutations. It's our salute to the sun. It's our salute to being thankful for another day. So if you could get up every day, look toward the rising sun, take some nice deep breaths, maybe go through a few sun salutations, it's going to set your day off in such a great way. And I think after creating a habit like that, and then you miss a few days, you will see the difference in the shift of your mood. So that's a great intention. First intention, remember, rise every day and look toward the sun and breathe mindfully. And if you want to, create movement with that with sun salutations. Second intention is to create great connectivity with others using rhythm. So maybe a drum circle. And this is something I want to get more into. I love drum circles. I love the sort of primal nature of it. You know, it's sort of letting go of the world and getting lost in the rhythm and letting your body move and letting your mind escape. Drum circles are awesome to do the week of summer solstice, but anytime. So maybe find a local drum circle and just go listen and close your eyes and get lost in the rhythm. They are so awesome. Or you can tell stories. You could form a circle with friends. You can tell stories. You can sing. Things like that. Connectivity. See if you can find something to do like that this week or specifically on the summer solstice. The third is be present amongst all of creation. So during this week or on the day of summer solstice, take a walk in nature. Really take a walk, maybe through the woods or on the beach, and just notice your surroundings, but also notice the light. Notice if you're at the beach, notice the light hitting the water. Notice if you're in the forest, notice the sunlight coming through the limbs and through the leaves and the beauty of it. Just sort of pay homage to that because it's a beautiful thing. And if you can absorb it in the environment of nature, it really brings it full circle to you how important that our sun and our light is. The fourth intention is to be tactile with the elements of nature. And this one is a really great one to do with children. So what I mean for you to do is go out, maybe grab yourself a basket and go out in the forest or on the beach and gather some things that nature is sitting there providing for you. Maybe you're going to pick some wildflowers. Maybe you're going to grab some limbs or some pieces of bark that's fallen off a tree. Maybe some seashells, you know, sea glass. Whatever you can find in nature that's sitting there that looks pretty to you or the child that you're with, and gather these things up. And this could be a great learning experience for a child. So gather them up, bring them home, and then create a mandala. You know, create something with symmetry, create something with sacred geometry that's going to teach you or teach the child and get you lost in the moment. This can be a very meditative experience. So mandalas can come in all shapes, all sizes, all forms of geometry. So find one that you can work with and enjoy that because it's a great thing to do. And it's something that is sort of like putting together a puzzle. It's very meditative. The fifth one is one I'm excited about. So it is, it's allow your dreams to speak to you during this powerful astrological time. Ancestors from our Celtic tradition gathered sacred plants that they believed had more potency on the longest day of the year. And one such plant is mugwort. So mugwort doesn't sound like anything you want to consume, but it's a pretty cool thing because it can really give you lucid dreams. So if you are interested in dream time, which I love dream time, to me dream time is escaping into another realm, basically. But if you drink mugwort tea, it makes your dreams more lucid. So that's something to consider. I have a mugwort tea that I enjoy, and if you're interested in that, email me or ask me in the comments and I'll send you a link for that. Or you can create your own. There's all sorts of recipes out there. But it really is a great thing to consume before bedtime, and especially during this week of summer solstice. So those are five things that you can do during this week of summer solstice, or you can reserve them for the day of summer solstice. You can try one, you can try all, but they're all going to bring something positive to your life. And I think it's an important, these are all important things to incorporate daily, not just this week or not just on that day. So anyway, I hope everyone has a happy summer solstice week, summer solstice day. Remember, every day is a gift, and let's make the most of it. Thanks, you guys. Namaste.